Living in Taunton or Bridgwater has a massive perk, and that is that we live the closest to the sun. Now, you might be thinking, oh, Mr. Cole, what are you talking about? You've lost the plot. Well, you'd be completely wrong. I lost the plot many years ago.
Along the Taunton and Bridgwater Canal, which is the blue line here, there is a to-scale representation of our solar system. Look, there is Taunton, and there is Bridgwater. And in the middle is me, right next to the sun.
Yes, I am here at the sun. And here it is, in all its glory. You can see just how big it is. And I want you to take a moment just to see how big this is. Now, I'm a pretty tall teacher, but the sun is even bigger than me. If you go that way to Bridgwater, or that way to Taunton, you'll find every single planet in our solar system, all to scale. And that's scale to the size of the planet, and also in scale from the distance away from the sun. So, I've wrapped up warm, I've got my helmet, I've got my bike. Let's go and find all the planets. Which one do you think is going to be first?
Bicycle, bicycle, bicycle. I want to ride my bicycle.
And you can see how far I've cycled, just literally that's the sun right there. Already found Mercury. However, Mercury's a little bit broken, so I've got an alternative plan.
And almost directly next to the sun on our map is Mercury.
But I've cycled over to Mercury on the other side, so towards Bridgwater is the opposite way. And it also has all the planets, and you can see here the size of Mercury. It's no bigger than a petit pois. So let's carry on and find our next planet. About 30 seconds away from Mercury, I've now found Venus.
On our map, Venus is literally about a few millimetres away from Mercury.
So here is Venus, bigger than Mercury was. Still very small planet. And still very close to the sun. So let's go and try and find our home planet.
Don't stop me now.
I've only been cycling for, I literally just got on my bike, and already I found our home planet, Earth.
Similarly to how little I'm cycling, I'm also hardly moving on my map as we find Earth.
So there is Earth, our home planet, and you can see how small that is there. And obviously that's to represent the size of the planet that we live on. So you can see there the scale.
That bouncy ball sized object is to represent our huge Earth here. And it just shows how huge our solar system is.
Now, let's go and try and find Mars.
I'm a rocket ship on my way to Mars on a collision course. I am a satellite.
And less than a minute away from where the Earth is, I've now found Mars.
The furthest outer planet is still incredibly close to the sun.
And you can see Mars there. Still very small planet. And it's the furthest inner planet away from the sun. So we'll now move on to try and find the first of the outer planets.
Stop me now. I'm having such a good time. I'm having a ball.
Just over 5 minutes away from where we were just at Mars, I've now found Jupiter.
We step further away on our map to find Jupiter.
And you can see, this is now a massive difference between the other planets we've already seen. It is the biggest planet in our solar system, with a diameter of 139,000 kilometers. Huge compared to other planets, still nothing compared to the sun. But bigger than the others. So, onwards to the next one. Just over about 5 minutes away from Jupiter, I've now found Saturn.
And Saturn is the first noticeably larger distance on our map.
And you can see Saturn is just a little bit smaller than Jupiter, but although it lacks in size, it makes up with its rings and 82 moons compared to Jupiter's 79. 82 moons, mad. Onward to our next, just as we hear a train approaching. As I overtake all the vans and cars, I know we're different as we can't be late. I gotta make an important day. We've been cycling for about another 15 minutes, which makes sense because Saturn is about halfway between our next planet and the Sun. And our next planet is none other than Uranus.
A huge gap now as we find ourselves on the outskirts of Crouched St. Michael for Uranus.
And look, you can see, even though it doesn't compare to the likes of Jupiter and Saturn in size, it's definitely bigger than our four inner planets. In fact, it is over three times bigger than any of the other four inner planets. So that is Uranus. Now on to our next one. And a further 15 minutes cycling, and I've finally found our last planet, Neptune.
Now we find ourselves in Taunton to locate Neptune.
And you see the size of Neptune just there, and you can see that it is a very similar size to Uranus. In fact, Uranus is just over 1,000 kilometers larger in the diameter than Neptune, so incredibly similar. Incredibly similar, but still nothing compared to Jupiter or Saturn, and certainly nothing compared to the Sun back where we started, but still a lot bigger than our four inner planets. So that is our last planet, but there is one more thing we need to see along our trail before we end things. And finally, after cycling for over an hour, we finally made it to the end of the solar system trail at Pluto.
And Pluto is found directly between the Brewhouse Theatre and Morrison's.
And you can tell that this representation of the solar system was created before 2006. It's actually set up in 1997. Because since 2006, Pluto was downgraded from a planet to what is now known as a dwarf planet. Sorry, what? If it isn't a proper planet, though, I should probably go back to Neptune to end the video. But I'm a sweaty mess. Oh, go on then. Well, I'm back at, there it is, back at Neptune, and nearly 5 billion kilometers from the Sun, or about 6 miles along the canal. But this representation just shows how huge our solar system really is. And if you ever get the chance, come walk or cycle along the route and try and find all the planets. But for now, I'm off for a nice warm shower.